Hi, welcome back. So I hope that tutorial was very useful for you and try to understand how you can use this to do your money management before you can get into any trade. Now, the couple of things you want to do, you want to turn on the notifications for this app because every now and then we'll send out a notification telling you there's a webinar that's coming up. So if you have some things that you'd like to learn about the Forex industry or the futures industry or the stock markets, we're generally talking about techniques and price action methods which can come very handy. Now, I'd like to just let you know, this app was originally built for me to use, and I am now opening this up for the rest of the world out there to get in on it. So I really hope you find this useful. It's something I really needed a lot for myself, because every time I put my stop loss in, by the time that the trade gets ready, I'm like, oh no, wait, now I need a different stop number. And I used to always go back and input all the information, and that was causing me a big headache. So I made this. This is a very quick, fast hack where it helps you keep track of your the right amount so you can keep track of your progress. Now, the two different methods and why they're important. If you want to do percentage, this is more geared towards if you're trying to work with compounding. All right. If you have a high win percentage, then you might as well go with a percentage allocation. So you want to do a percentage amount. And then that way you can compound as your trades get better and better. You're trading a little bit higher and higher size automatically, right? As you keep winning, your size keeps increasing automatically at the 2% level. However, if you want to keep track of your balance and say every 3 months, you want to then evaluate and see how am I trading? How good are my trades? But some of you guys might be trading on the 1 hour, some of you guys are trading on the 10 minutes, some of you guys are trading on the 3 minute chart. So whatever time frame you're trading, let's say you're trading multiple time frames, you might have a risk tolerance of, let's say, $50 per trade. I don't care what trade I'm in, no more than $50. Then you want to go with the amount, okay? Because when you do it based on the amount, sometimes you'll have a trade that's 50 pip stop loss, another time you'll have a trade that's only 10 pip stop loss. If you use the same lot size, one loss is going to be so big compared to the other, when in actuality, it's only two trades, right? You want to know how well you're doing by keeping the amount stable, trade after trade after trade. So this is ideal for those who are trying to look for a little bit of perfection into their trading, trying to find out where do I need to improve? What is going wrong? What is going right with my trading? So I personally use the dollar amount constantly. And then every few months I evaluate and be like, okay, do I need to raise the number a little bit? And I do that manually. So that can be very useful for you too. So they're both available. It is for you to decide what is more useful for you. So I hope this entire tutorial was useful for you. I look forward to seeing you in some of our future webinars. Don't forget, you can also pick up a free course from us by using the links below. Otherwise, you can don't forget to check out our other very popular app called FX Meter, in which I'm actually looking at the markets and trying to understand every morning before I sit down to trade, where is the money flow? This is something we do in-house. It is not programmed. We do it in-house. A colleague of mine wakes up every morning early. He goes through all 28 Forex currency pairs, looks at them one by one, and picks out which is the ideal pair. So don't forget again, please make use of this app. It is very powerful, very clean, very user-friendly. Please leave us a wonderful 5-star review, and I look forward to seeing you guys soon in the future webinars. Cheers. Thank you.